Hello, this is Noreen Crone-Findlay. I'm the author of Potholder Loom Weaving, and it's a wonderful book, and it's full of all kinds of marvelous information. One of the things that I do talk about in the book is about using your shed stick. Now, this video is about how a shed stick is a very useful thing when you're working with the 27 peg large size potholder loom. I really like weaving with the weaving hooks that I carve from chopsticks, and when I'm looking for a chopstick to carve my weaving hook from, I like the ones that have the sort of flat bit at the one end. The ones that are totally round all the way are great as shed sticks, but not as great as these ones for carving your weaving hooks. And I will post the link to the YouTube video that shows you how to carve your own hooks. Now, if you are lucky enough to have an Afghan hook that will reach all the way across, then that's great. If you aren't, then having your one shed stick inserted up here and having another shed stick that does, again, reach all the way across is really handy. I'm going to show you how to do that both on the wooden potholder loom and the Harrisville Designs metal one. I just want to point out something here, and that is some people are getting a little confused when they're warping with yarn. Now, you notice how the upper edge has loops on every nail, and yet the lower edge, it looks like you've got an empty nail. That is just the way it's supposed to be. That's not a problem. Your yarn is going to come around at a diagonal and will be moving through these strands here. And when you're chaining around, you'll do two chain stitches in this long diagonal. But you do have, even though it looks wrong, this is right. And there, I did another video showing you how to warp and weave on the 27 peg looms. Now, I just want to mention one more thing, and that is that if you don't have knitting needles, if you're not a knitter, then you can make shed sticks. You can use knitting needles, and you can often buy knitting needles from the thrift shop. There will always be orphan needles that need homes. But I got a bag of the dowels, quarter inch dowels, at a garage sale. And then I discovered that they sell them in the dollar store. And these ones are 12 inches long, which goes across the loom really nicely. Sharpen the one end so it's like a knitting needle. And then use a nail file or emery board to just smooth that off, and then you'll have a wonderful shed stick. Now, you can, I'm going to be using the two of these dowels as the permanent shed stick up here. It always goes above the top of the side nails. There's a gap there at the top, and that's where the shed stick lives. Now, my weaving hook, see, it doesn't weave all the way across. So, that's not really a problem. What I'll do is, for my first row, I'm going to scoot it in at the middle, up at the top. I'm going to push down so you can see more easily. At the top, I'm going to push the camera down a bit more. You slide your weaving hook, or if you don't have a weaving hook and don't want to make one, you can even use just a regular crochet hook. You're not going all the way through, and that's not a problem. You're going to scoot down to the bottom of the loom, and I always recommend that you do your picking up at the top, because it's easier to see what you're doing. But at the lower edge. Now I'm going to pull a loop of yarn up that's wide enough to go across my loom. I'm going to take my hook out between the first two nails. I'm going to pull it up, and now I'm going to lift it off my weaving hook, and I'm going to take my weaving hook now and scooch across and pick it up off my finger and scoot down all the way. I need to come up a bit here so you can see a little more clearly. So you can see that I've placed it on the lowest right-hand peg. It's the yarn was too loose, so I pulled on the left-hand side to tighten it up. Not tight, just enough. Now, for the second row, I'm going to grab another one of the shed sticks that I've made, and I'm going to go and pick up the warp strands that are behind the, you can see behind, they're behind the first shed stick, and these are ones that you went over in your first row, and this time you're going to go under them for the second and all the even numbered rows. And so now I've got my shed stick going all the way across, and I don't need it to be right up at the top. I'm going to just bring it down, and again I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to slide my weaving hook into the shed that this shed stick has opened. I'm going to come across, and my chihuahua rescue cross mix little guy has suddenly come down with the sneezes, and so he's standing quite close to me sneezing, so if you hear funny snorts, that's him. And then you see how I've come in from the edge. I've got the loop, I've taken it off my fingers, just going to make sure it will go all the way across. Now it will. And I have followed in the shed of this second row, placed my loop onto the second nail, and I'm just tightening up and pushing down. Now I pull this loop out. Just going to lift up a bit so that you can see a little better here, and try to line that up with the camera. And now I'm on my third row, and so it doesn't really matter where I go in. Scooch down, I go into the shed, I'm holding on to it down here. I'm going to pick up a length of yarn. You can see I'm using two strands of a cotton thread that's been, looks like it's been made, braided, and one strand of sock yarn. And so I've got my loop, there we go, in, I pull it across, and I've got way too much thread, so I just kind of pull it back, and now I'm going back up. I'm going to run in that shed until I find where my loop is, bring it, my hook down, catch my loop, bring it across, place it on the third nail, pull over with my left hand so that my row tightens up, and I push down. Now, because the fourth row is of course an even row, I pull my strands back and I use the second weaving stick. Always leave this one in. Your second weaving stick will go in and out of the even numbered rows, but your first weaving, your first shed stick is going to stay in there all the time. And I'm weaving it across. And this row, I'll just weave with a crochet hook. So you can see that. And I like to be able to just bring this one down closer. And I don't need to have a full length hook. Get myself a nice loop of yarn here. And I can just scoot in a comfortable distance, drop the loop onto the hook, and come across with it. And I've gone way too far with my loop, so I'm pulling back somewhat. And because I'm just using the crochet hook, I'm not able to go all the way across both times. So I'm going to have to make three passes. So here's the third time. And there we go. So row four is done. It's an even row. I pull it out. And then I will scoot up to the top, pick up a loop, and carry on merrily weaving away. And I always put my finger in to show me where I want to stop and pick up my next set of strands here. And even though I'm going super slow to do this, that's not a real time kind of thing, because once you get in the habit of doing this, it goes very, very quickly. And picking up your row with the extra shed stick is no slower than using a hook that reaches all the way across. So using a shed stick like this to work your way across your loom is a very handy thing to do. Now, I'm going to move this out of the way and move the Harrisville loom into place. And on the Harrisville loom, I have three strands of very fine yarn, two strands of sock yarn, and one strand of lace weight yarn. And I'm warped all the way across, and you can see that the sock yarn is self-patterning, and so there, that's why you get the various gradations there. Now, because I had to park this yarn, what I've done is I've wrapped around the side pegs so that the yarn won't loop off while I'm talking. I'm going to show you what I do if I'm doing my hang tag that I made for the three-stitch, three-row repeat for twill. And because it's three rows, I'm not going to be able to use the same, like with the tabby, it's under, over, all the way across. Now, I'm going to follow what the first pattern row is, and I'm going to put my shed stick in following the first pattern row of the twill. And so as I work across, I'm going over one set of warp strands. I'm snagged on my hook there. There we go. And under two all the way across. So I will not have, what I'll be doing is I will leave this shed stick in at the top of my loom, and when I'm doing row one of my twill, I will always follow, I'll just scoot my hook in there, and that will be my row one. And for row two, I will use the pickup stick and pick up the stitches for row two, and then scoot my hook in and weave the row. Same thing with row three. I pull this out after row two. Row three, I'm going to pick up the stitches for row three and then scooch my crochet hook in and grab that yarn and pull it through. And it may look a lot slower to do it this way, but that's because I'm going slowly to explain it to you, and it really does speed up quite nicely. So the shed stick has opened row one for me, and so I can just pick up row one just like that, and every time I weave row one, it's already pre-picked up for me. Put it in there, push it down, make sure it's in the right tension on the loom. Perfect, it is. Okay, and so this time I'm going to pick up the rows that I need to do, the warp strands that I need to lift and push down, the ones I need to push down for row two. And so I just zoom across my loom, picking up, pushing down. And I do like to do this up at the top because it's so much easier to see what I'm doing when I've got the loops up there at the top, and it's just a much simpler process to be able to see what I'm doing. And so now I'm going to bring this shed stick down, and I will shoot my crochet hook through, fold over a loop of yarn, pull it through, and put my finger here and scoot in with my crochet hook, pick up that loop, go across, oh, pick up all my loops, not just some of my loops. I missed one of the strands, so I will pick that up again. Here we go. And run it along the shed stick in the shed. The shed is the gap between your upper layer of warp strands and your lower ones. Push that down. I pull this out, and now I need to weave row three. So I'm going up to the top again. I'm going to put down my crochet hook. I'm going to pick up the one. I had to change my battery there, so there was a quick edit away. When I was changing my battery, I thought, you know, I should just point out that the three stitch, three row twill that I'm using is on page 58 of the Potholder Loom Weaving book. So that if you're looking for that particular pattern, it's on page 58. So I'm going to now, I'm picking up row three of my three stitch twill, and need to make sure that I'm doing this right. One of the hints that I always find that is helpful with when you're doing your picking up your row is to check and make sure that you land on the right stitch at the end of your row, so that if you're supposed to end up going over the last one and you're coming out under, then you know, whoops, I need to look at this again. So, and then just pull your stick out and redo it. So now I can just go in with my crochet hook or my little chopstick weaving hook, pick up, okay, I gotta get myself a loop of yarn and bring it across, take it off my finger, and then pick up the next set of stitches. And like I said, this looks slow to do it this way, but it isn't. And it does solve a world of problems if you can't find an Afghan hook or Tunisian hook, and you don't want to carve your own crochet, weaving hooks, then this is the way to be able to work with just a regular crochet hook on your loom. Because I hate to say it, but I really don't care for these weaving hooks that come with the looms. The wire ones, they're just, I don't like them. I find them clumsy and they're not a happy choice for me. So I've got my first three rows woven. So now I get to scoot through the row one weaving shed stick at the top. And I'm picking up my loop, bringing it through, and I'm stopping here and then coming to where my fingers are resting and picking up. And there's row one. So I'm going to finish weaving these two samples up for you, and then I will come back and just, I guess, finish up with you then. So I'm wondering, perhaps I should weave some of this in slow motion. No, on fast forward. Okay, so I will weave some of these, a few more rows in fast forward, just so that you can see the rhythm of the process. And there we go. Both of the sample swatches are woven now. And the some questions and answers. Does it change the way the weaving turns out? Not at all. Can you use this technique with other twills other than the three row one? Absolutely yes. You'll just need a single shed stick, though, when you're working the other twill patterns in the book, because you'll just be picking up one row at a time because they progress through a number of rows. Can you use this technique with loops? Absolutely yes. It works just great. Can you use it on the smaller looms? Absolutely yes. If you don't have a weaving hook that reaches all the way across your smaller loom, definitely use the shed stick technique. So this is just one of those kind of useful techniques, and I hope it's very helpful to you. So happy weaving, enjoy your wonderful potholder looms, and we'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.